When the water was gone, Billy jumped up and ran back to the house, and she hid behind a tree. She followed him back to the house to a tap on the outside of the house, to which they'd shut off the water. Billy opened it up all the way until a small trickle of water began to creep out. He knelt there, letting the drop drip, drip slowly, until he had perhaps a couple of tablespoonfuls of water in the palm of his hand. As the sun beat down on his little back, it came clear to her the trouble he had gotten into for playing with the holes the week before. The lecture he'd received about the importance of not wasting water, the reason he hadn't asked her to help him. It took almost 20 minutes for the drops to fill his hands. When he stood up and began the trek backwards, she was there in front of him, his little eyes just filled with tears. "I'm not wasting," was what he said. As he began to walk, she joined him with a small pot of water from the kitchen. She let him tend to the fall. As she stayed away, it was his job. She stood on the edge of the woods, watching the most beautiful heart she'd ever known, working so hard to save another life. As the tears that rolled down her face began to hit the ground, other drops and more drops had suddenly joined them. She looked up at the sky. It was as if God's self was weeping with pride. Well, of course, this may well have been just a coincidence, if coincidences really do happen. But those we might say that sort of miracle doesn't exist, that it was bound to rain sometime. I can't argue with that. All that that mother could say, however, was that the rain that came that day saved their farm, just like the actions of that little boy saved another life. That was God. And God is love. If you love me, you will obey my commandments. And the greatest of these is love. Let us sing the hymn 595. We are pilgrims on a journey, fellow travelers on the road. Thank you. Let us pray. God, grant us the serenity to accept the things we cannot change, the courage to change the things we can, and the wisdom to know the difference. We call to mind our concerns and commitments, and join our prayers for peace and well-being to the prayers of the whole Church, as they are offered on this day for the whole world. We remember the people we know who are in trouble, and pray for healing and happiness for them. We seek God's encouragement for honest trade and just commerce, for medicine and education, for the gifts and aptitudes in every person which serve justice and beauty in community living. We pray for peace on earth, for the generous sharing and the care of the earth's resources, the responsible sharing of the earth's problems, for understanding of others and willingness to regard the diversity of human culture as more stimulating than threatening, for the turning of swords into plowshares and spears into pruning hooks. We pray for the Church by all its names and in all its places, for its continuing usefulness as a channel of grace and hope, for its witness to unity and justice, for its commitment to hospitality and compassion. We commend to you our families and friends. Let us ask God to help us in the days of the coming week. These prayers we ask in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray.
Come. Amen.